In this tutorial, I want to talk about a relatively basic surfacing technique that uses some of the SOLIDWORKS' surface features, which is called face replacement. And basically what this allows you to do is to get the benefits of the very precise control you get through using the surfacing features to affect solid bodies in a way that's not quite as cumbersome and in-depth as regular surface modeling. So to show you what I mean, we're going to think about modeling a cushion on a piece of furniture. Typically, a cushion is supposed to look kind of soft and poofy and maybe have kind of an irregular surface as opposed to just looking like extruded plastic. And face replacement can be an effective technique for helping out with this kind of a model. So I'm going to start just by extruding out a profile. I'm going to go to my right plane here, and I'm going to basically block out the shape that I want just using straight lines. And we're going to make it look more like a cushion using face replacement. So, you know, I'm kind of imagining a seat cushion. This is the side view of it. Maybe the back of the chair is like this. There's legs down here, armrests up here. This is kind of the bottom cushion of the chair. So that's what the side profile looks like. I can extrude this out. That's how wide the seat is. Okay. So how do we make this look more like a cushion? Well, you might say fillets. And to a certain extent, we can use fillets to smooth it out. But that's still not going to change the fact that, you know, it's totally flat up here. Even if I had made this curved, it would just be curved in one dimension since it's extruded out. You know, there's no kind of the bulge that you would expect to see on the sides here. So let's try to address some of those things. What I can do is use a fillet to get rid of this very, very sharp corner up here, so let's, I'm just going to go with that. Okay, so we've rounded off the front a little bit, but it's still a very hard, blocky looking object. So let's see what we can do about affecting the top of the chair. Make it look a little softer, a little more curved. We want to add some curve in this direction as opposed to from front to back like this. And actually, just thinking about this, I think I want to do the fillet after this operation. Okay. So what we want to do is basically define a surface using our surfacing tools that is going to replace this flat face of this solid object. And so let's just set up how that's going to work first. And I just realized it's probably going to be easier if this is extruded across the right plane so that it's symmetrical as opposed to being over on one side like this because, well, it's easy enough just to define a new plane. That's not a big deal. So, we've done this before. I'm selecting my right plane, which I want my new plane to be parallel to, and I selected the midpoint of this edge here. So, with those selected, if I go ahead and define a new plane, that plane will be right going across our seat like this. I'm just going to call this my midplane. Okay, and on the midplane, I'm just going to draw, you know, some curvature. The seat bulging up a bit, like this. Okay. Now, what I also want to do is have some kind of a bulge in this direction, kind of like this. So, I think I'll use a swept surface for that. So, I'm going to choose this spline and this point, and we're going to define a new plane there. Okay. And I'm going to go ahead and define how that's going to. So I want this to be symmetrical, so I'm going to wiggle this handle. And I actually have to get a center line going here. I've got this handle, and I want it to be perpendicular to my center line. Let's go and ensure that this is smooth. Like that. Oops, didn't mean to leave the sketch yet. I now need to mirror this across the center line. Okay. So now I've got a profile and a path for a swept surface. And I'm going to use my swept surface tool. Profile is the sketch. Path is this one. Okay. So we see that our new surface has been swept across where we want it to be in terms of the seat. It's a separate body at this point. It's not done anything to that solid seat model. But, you know, this surface defines what I want this top, the top of the seat to look like instead of that hard, flat surface that we had. And this is where face replacement comes in. So notice here, my surface body is that sweep that I've done. My solid body is that extruded block cushion. So face replacement. I'm going to use my replace face tool in the surfacing toolbar. Replace parameters. The first one is, I'm not getting that. Target faces for replacement. So what face do I want to replace with this surface body? And I want to click on the top face of that extruded solid block as what I'm going to replace. And then what am I going to replace it with? The surface that I swept out. So once I say OK, now it's a little hard to see because the original surface body is still there. So I'm going to go ahead and turn this off. But now, the top of our cushion has that nice curved, bulged form that we were going for. What happened is that the top face of the solid body got replaced, got redefined by that surface body that we had swept out. Now, what's important to notice is that this surface body is still here, but I don't need it anymore. So I'm actually going to insert a delete body feature to get rid of it. I'm not just going to hide it, I actually want to get rid of it. So I'm going to select my surface sweep here, and there's a number of ways to do this. Remember, this is the surface body that I'm talking about. I can right-click on it and say delete body, or I can go insert features, and I believe it is delete body here. They're the same thing. Delete body applies to surface bodies or solid bodies, either or. Okay, so bodies to delete, surface sweep one. Once I do this, now I've actually got a body delete feature in my feature tree that gets rid of that surface body that I've already used as a tool and don't need anymore. If I were to rewind to before that feature, the surface is there. Go to the end, the surface is gone, and I'm only left with my solid body. Okay, so that's basically how face replacement works. And if I were really going to model this whole cushion, I would probably do that for almost all of the faces of the block. And then I might add some fillets to smooth out the transitions. Or we could use some of the advanced surfacing techniques, which we'll look at in later tutorials. Just to show one more thing. Let's say I wanted to add a little bulge to the side here, and I'm not going to spend a lot of time getting a very precise surface for this. I just want to, let's see, let me get myself a plane here at the back. Just control-clicking back here. I'm just going to do an extruded surface to demonstrate this. So, clicking on this plane, I'm going to start a sketch. Let's see, let's get a head-on view here. And I just want something that bulges out a bit. Notice that it doesn't matter whether the surface that is going to redefine a face is inside that face, outside that face, or both. The replace face feature is smart enough to just figure out all the geometry that needs to happen and whether it's cutting away at the solid body or adding more material. So I'm deliberately doing this so that it's kind of part of it is inside and part of it is outside. And I'm just going to use extruded surface to bring that out all the way out here. Okay, so let's see. I want to replace this side face with this surface that I have extruded out. I'm going to do replace face again. The target face is this side face here. It's already seen that I've extruded out a surface, so it's pre-selected that. Okay, that's fine. The problem is, I want this to happen on both sides symmetrically, and I can't just mirror this replace face feature. That's not going to work. What I have to do is actually take my extruded surface, mirror that body, and then do another replace face feature on the other side. So let's do that real quick. I'm going to take the, I'm selecting my surface extrude body. It's still here even after the replace face feature because I haven't deleted it. I'm going to select my midplane. Let's mirror that across. I'm mirroring a surface body, not a feature or face. Okay, so now the surface is over on the other side, and I can do another replace face feature. So what face am I replacing? This one. What am I replacing it with? This surface. Okay. The last thing I'm going to do is delete these two surfaces that I don't need anymore, and I can actually do that in one feature. Insert, Features, Delete Body, and I'm going to select both of these. So they'll both go away in the same delete operation. Okay. So now it's starting to look, well, it still needs a lot of work, but it's starting to look a little more like a cushion, and that's basically how you use the Replace Face feature.